The only operational fifth-generation anti-ship missile of the West today is the Naval Strike Missile, shortly NSM. It has significant advantages over its previous generation counterparts. The air-launched version of the NSM, the Joint Strike Missile, shortly JSM, is one of the two missiles in its class compatible with the F-35's internal weapon bays in the world. These days, when we are going through the beginning of the Second Cold War, they are one of the most remarkable new weapon systems. As the weapon detective, we're investigating the NSM and JSM, deadly siblings of new missile family. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel before we start, and give us a thumbs up if you like our video. To be notified of our new video, please click the bell button. The NSM has game-changer features in naval warfare. So why was such an innovative anti-ship missile developed by the Norwegian Kongsberg Defence and Aerospace instead of the defense companies of other major Western countries such as the USA or France? The answer to this question lies in geography and history. At the early stage of the First Cold War, Norway, controlling the exit of the Baltic and Barents Seas, had been keeping in service a considerable huge fleet consisted of major surface combatants. In 1960, the Royal Norwegian Navy decided to replace its big warships with small fast attack crafts. In 1962, Norway also started to study on an indigenous anti-ship missile development project because no other Western countries was working on developing a system that could meet the needs of the Royal Norwegian Navy. The fruit of this project, the Penguin missile, became operational in 1970. Since then, Norway has become one of the world's leading countries in anti-ship missile technologies. In the late 1990s, Norway started a study on a new anti-ship missile as the replacement of the Penguin. The program goal was that the new missile, called NSM, was capable of responding to new threats that may arise after 2015. After extensive trials, the Norwegian Royal Navy gave the initial serial production order in 2007. A Skjold-class missile boat, KMN Glimt, conducted the first NSM fire test 5 years later. In 2013, the missile was tested for the first time with a live warhead and hit successfully the decommissioned Oslo-class corvette KMN Trondheim. The main design criteria for NSM, defined as the fifth-generation anti-ship missile, is to have higher resistance against active and passive self-defense systems of the ships than the current ones. To achieve this purpose, Kongsberg Defence and Aerospace engineers prioritized stealth. The fuselage, made of composite materials, has the design that efficiently reduces the radar cross-section. There is no active sensor on the NSM to avoid enemy ships' electronic support measure systems. The missile has high-resolution passive imaging infrared, shortly IIR, seeker as a guidance system. The advanced software of the guidance system can independently detect, identify, and discriminate the ships. It can also choose its target autonomously. Thanks to this feature, the NSM can engage a ship which is near the coast, and differentiate a surface combatant from nearby civilian ships. The missile can fly over and around the land. During the cruise phase, the NSM uses its GPS, inertial and terrain reference navigation systems. Thanks to this ability, the NSM can navigate the coastal waters with a large number of rocks and islets without any problems. Also, the missile can cruise smoothly on the land too. When an obstacle is detected, it can reset its course independently. This gives it a unique capability not found in other anti-ship missiles. Naturally, an enemy surface combatant sailing close to its own shores or being in its own harbor awaits the threat from the direction from the sea. For this reason, the enemy's defense systems focus their attention toward the sea. The NSM has a design that turns this into an advantage. The NSM can attack its target over land after infiltrating the enemy mainland at a point far from the detection range of the sensors. During the terminal phase, to avoid the closing weapon systems, the missile starts to conduct the high-G evasive maneuvers, very hard to predict, which consist of turning in all three dimensions. The NSM, which can track the target in different directions, can execute its final attack with the most suitable angle. Its circular error probable is smaller than 1 meter. Thanks to its GPS, inertial and terrain reference navigation systems, the NSM is also effective against the land targets. In 2016, the Royal Norwegian Navy officially confirmed this capability. The titanium-coated warhead of the NSM is insensitive, which means only programmable fuse can activate it. In case of the missile may not find an infrared signature that matches the pre-programmed targets, it destroys itself. The missiles can be deployed on the ship for 3 years without checking. Their shelf life is 30 years by overhauling every 5 to 10 years. The NSM has been currently preferred by Germany, Malaysia, Norway, Poland, and the USA. The Royal Norwegian Navy uses the missile on its Fridtjof Nansen-class frigates and Skjold-class corvettes. Soon, we will see the NSM on the Maharaja Lela-class frigates of Malaysia. Also, the US Navy will equip its Freedom and Independence-class littoral combat ships, as well as the Constellation-class frigates, with this missile. Poland uses the NSM with its coastal defense batteries. Similarly, the USA preferred this missile for the same mission. Today, more than 21,000 US Marines are operating in the West Pacific, many of whom are inside the first island chain near China. To increase their offensive and defensive capabilities, soon the US Marine Corps will have a new vehicle called the JLTV Rogue Fires. Developed as a part of the Navy Marine Expeditionary Ship Introduction System, this system consists of the NSM launch tubes on an unmanned version of the JLTV 4x4 vehicle. The NSM is 3.96 meters long. Its wingspan is 0.7 meter inside the launch tube and 1.36 meter after launched. The weight of the missile is 407 kilograms. Thanks to the microturbo TRI-40 turbojet engine, the NSM can reach the maximum speed of Mach 0.95. Its range is over 185 kilometers. The missile has 125 kilogram high explosive blast fragmentation warhead. The air launch multi-role version of the missile is the JSM. It has suitable sizes for the weapon base of the F-35 Lightning II. The JSM is still not operational, but will be one of the two proper-sized missiles for the weapon base of this aircraft. The other system is the Turkish SOMJ. Norway funds the JSM development program with Australia. The F-35 will be able to carry two of these in its internal base and two additional missiles externally. It has a two-way communications line so that the JSM can communicate with the command center or other missiles in the air. Different from the NSM, the JSM would reach the maximum range of over 185 kilometers in low flight profile or over 560 kilometers in high low flight profile. The dimensions of the missile is also different from its ship launch version. The 4-meter-long JSM has a stowed wingspan of 0.48 meters. It can be equipped with a 375 kg warhead. But in this case, the maximum range of the missile reduces to 370 kilometers. After the completion of the development phase, the first test fire was conducted from an F-16 Fighting Falcon in 2018. Kongsberg Defense and Aerospace and project partner Lockheed Martin aim to complete the necessary software updates for using the F-35 Lightning II by 2021. If everything goes as planned, the JSM would be operational by 2025. Japan and Norway have already ordered the JSM. Also, Australia, South Korea, the UK, and the USA have announced their interest in this missile for use with their F-35s. Japan's acquirement of JSM is something that deserves special attention. After the Second World War, the Allies had constitutionally banned Japan to possess guided land attack missiles. So, Japan's Air Self-Defense Force had only a limited amount of precision-guided bombs. However, after 2017, the USA has lifted this ban. Japan Air Self-Defense Forces have two important air bases on the Kyushu Island, Yutabara Air Base and Suiki Airfield. Also, there is one big air base of Japan Maritime Self-Defense Forces on the island, Kanaya Airfield. The F-35s took off from these bases can reach a suitable range to attack all the main naval facilities of the East Sea Fleet of the Chinese Navy without any radar detection with the JSMs. The same situation is also possible for the Japanese Lightning IIs took off from Chitose and Misawa air bases against the Russian Navy. That's why Japan's JSM acquirement is important enough to change the balances in the region. Kongsberg Defense and Aerospace is also working on the VLS launching and submarine launching versions of the NSM. As a new anti-ship missile, the NSM has not yet found an opportunity to be fired in anger. So, it has not got any combat experience. But the missile has proved itself with many important test fires. In 2014, the Royal Norwegian Navy frigate Kaimann Fridtjof Nansen used its NSM to sink the decommissioned amphibious assault ship USS Ogden in the naval exercise RIMPAC 2014 in the Pacific Ocean. In the same year, the Independence-class littoral combat ship USS Coronado conducted the first launch of the NSM of the US Navy. The missile was fired from a launcher positioned on ship's flight deck. During that time, the NSM was competing with the RGM-84 Harpoon of Boeing and the LRASM of Lockheed Martin for the US Navy's Over the Horizon Weapon System program. After these two companies were withdrawn from the program in 2017, the NSM was officially selected as the winner in 2018. The US service designation of the missile is the RGM-184A. During RIMPAC 2018, the units of the United States Army Pacifica fired an NSM from the shore to sink the decommissioned Newport-class landing ship USS Racine. 1 year later, another Independence-class littoral combat ship USS Gabriel Gifford fired this missile to sink the decommissioned Oliver Hazard Perry-class frigate USS Ford. Unlike the USS Colorado, her missile launchers were not on the flight deck, but just behind the 57mm bow gun. Since then, the USS Gabriel Giffords has preserved the NSMs and has been deployed in the seas of China. The Western Pacific is the hottest region of the Second Cold War in the seas. Japan and the USA, which see this region as a priority security area, have advanced missile design and production capabilities. It is interesting, however, that these two countries prefer the NSM instead of developing a new system. Clearly, even this fact is a proof of how successful the NSM is with its superior features. It would not be a prophecy to say that its air launch version, the JSM, will also be preferred by many F-35 users in the future and will be used in many important conflicts. Thanks for watching our video. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and give us a thumbs up if you like our video. To be notified of our new videos, please click the bell button.